Andrew, this is huge news, obviously stating what everybody can deduce for themselves. Carlos Ghosn is the chairman of the Nissan-Renault group. And to put into some context in terms of his influence, keep in mind that Nissan-Renault is Carlos Ghosn, and he is the company. They march to his drumbeat. And this report that he has been arrested, that Japanese authorities are investigating whether or not he misreported or underreported his compensation. Those are details that we're still trying to determine this morning. But if he is fired, as you're reporting that there are indications out of Japan that he has been fired or will be fired, I should say, the implications are enormous because he is not only the person who was the architect of putting together Nissan and Renault. If you go back to the early 90s, he is the man who served for as CEO for a number of years of the alliance, and most recently has been chairman. And he is no longer running day-to-day operations of Nissan Renault, but he essentially is the company. It is his influence, his guidance, his vision that sets the tone for the company, has set the tone for a number of years. Most recently, he was the architect of the company buying a stake in Mitsubishi and trying to weave Mitsubishi further into the Nissan-Renault alliance. So the reports that he has been arrested and will be fired for allegedly underreporting or misreporting his compensation, huge implications for Nissan-Renault, as well as for the entire Japanese business culture, because Carlos Ghosn is a giant, not only in the auto industry, but also in terms of Japanese business. Guys, back to you.
Hey, Phil, let me ask, because I already talked to someone earlier this morning, literally as all of this was just crossing the tape. Do you think this is ultimately going to put Nissan and Renault in play?
Hard to say. I would say initially it's too early to indicate that that would be the case. They are among all the automakers, one of the most aggressive in terms of expanding and growing. Financially, it's a company that's in relatively healthy shape. The question becomes whether or not the board of directors, particularly when it comes to this with the board of directors of Renault, if they look at this and they say, you know what, we are better served perhaps being part of another company. I think it's a little too soon to say that this is definitely going to be a catalyst for Nissan Renault being put in play.
Hey, Phil, it's such a weird phrase, underreporting his income over many years. Basically, that just means stealing from the company, right?
Well, it depends, Becky. I mean, we don't know the details yet. Is this a case where it's an income tax violation, so to speak? Or is this a case where, as you are suggesting or questioning...
That's what I can't figure out. It's such weird phraseology.
Yeah. And that's why we're going to hear from the representatives from Nissan Renault a little bit later on this morning. There's supposed to be a press conference. Hopefully, we'll get a few more details then. And obviously, we're waiting to hear more from the authorities in Japan.
Phil, the other question is, because this sounds to be an issue related to disclosure of what might be described as a secret compensation scheme, was it secret only in the context of what was reported in Tokyo, or was it what was reported everywhere? There almost seemed to be a demarcation in terms of how this story came about.
Great question. And it's unclear what was the genesis of this, Andrew. I think that's part of what needs to be determined. Is this a case where there was some evidence or a tip or something that sparked the investigators in Japan to start looking into his compensation and how it was being reported? Is there some indication that perhaps this also extends over to France and to Carlos Ghosn's representation for Renault? That's very unclear at this point. And certainly because this is a true global automaker, that's going to be one of the primary questions.